Morning to you. Thanks so much for being with us. I'm Christine Sorensen, coming to you live from this remote location. Actually, it's our Studio B right down the hall from our PTL studio. But this is because I want to show you this. This is a 3D printer whirring away right behind me. It's been here all morning thanks to a visit from the Carnegie Science Center Fab Lab. And we are making some really cool things here, including something for Penguins fans in honor of the Stanley Cup Final and the big win last night against the Predators. You could experience this yourself by having the Fab Lab come to you, just like it did to us here at KDKA this morning. Jon Doctorick is coordinator of the Mobile Fab Lab, and he's here to tell us all about the ultimate mobile maker lab and what it can bring to your doorstep. Good to see you.
Good morning. Thanks for having me.
This is so cool. So explain what the Mobile Fab Lab is.
The Mobile Fab Lab is obviously a mobile version of the fabrication laboratory that we have at the Carnegie Science Center.
Ah, see, FAB doesn't stand for fabulous. Fabrication, I see now, okay.
You can make things that are fabulous. I'll show you a few things in a moment, but it does stand for fabrication. So we have two mobile fab labs, and they can actually be brought out to schools or to sites. They can be booked for summer camps or brought into libraries. Literally provide a blank, empty room, and we can bring the vehicle and bring all the CAD, the computer-aided design, laptops, any equipment directly to your site and teach anybody grades 3 and up how to make their own stuff.
And we have some pictures of what the Mobile Fab Lab looks like. It was a little too big to bring here to KDKA, but we're looking at it here. And so say again where you go, where this Fab Lab can take.
We will travel anywhere, absolutely mm-hmm. anywhere.
You go to a lot of schools?
Correct. We do, a large portion of our visits are through schools, mm-hmm. Introducing students to the concept of digital design and fabrication. We've traveled all across Pennsylvania. We've traveled into West Virginia and Ohio, but we're on wheels. We can go anywhere.
And we're looking at the kids inside, so they step in and do the learning right in there.
They can. That's one of the uses. We do have the ability to bring students in. Majority of the time, we do take the equipment actually off the vehicles, and we set them up within the school,
okay.
Sort of modeling for schools and sites what a makerspace could look like at their own facility.
So tell me what this is making in this whole maker movement.
The making refers to the digital fabrication. Mm-hmm. So students of almost any age are very familiar with how to do digital design. They're familiar with computers, but they may not have had that connect yet between the actual what they can do on a computer screen and how machines can follow their commands and make that. So we have laser cutters and vinyl cutters, 3D printers and routing machines, and we can take anybody that has no experience whatsoever. Within 2 hours, we can have them creating and designing and making their own
objects. That is cool.
Objects.
Well, show us how it works then.
Great. So what I thought we would do is just sort of step down the line and look how the fabricating process works. For you might have seen the Penguins logo that was being 3D printed on
really
that one.
Cool. Yeah. So this is how it's designed on the computer first?
This is how it starts. This is the computer-aided design program itself. So this is something we could introduce, say, a participant to, is how to do a design software, get in and make something that they want to create. It's all about giving them the option to create something that's their own idea, not necessarily telling them what to do, and then ultimately teaching them how to create this 3D image and this 3D model inside of their computer. And then ultimately the machine that we're working with today is the mm-hmm. 3D printer, but like I said, we have numerous different machines that can be used. How the 3D printer actually functions is there's filament made from a material called polylactic acid. You can shorthand call it plastic. It's similar to plastic.
Okay.
And then these machines, these two 3D printers, these Ultimakers that I brought, this is just one type of 3D printer that's available, feeds that material up through.
Oh, that's what's in this cord here. Okay.
Yes, and there's a motor in the back that feeds the material at an appropriate rate. This is not something that somebody who's designing would have to know all of that. The machines figure that out automatically.
So the computer obviously is hooked to this.
Correct.
You can either telling it what to do.
Yeah, you can connect the computer to this, or you can load it with an old style SD card.
Oh, okay.
And then there's a robotic arm. So that's the important
part. And is it melting that plastic?
Yes, if you sort of imagine how a hot glue gun works, it's a similar in concept to that. So there's a very hot tip. And then the robotic arm.
Sorry, I'm going the wrong way. Want everybody to see what
there
it's doing. Okay.
So you can, the hot tip actually melts that plastic, and then it builds it up over a long period of time and actually creates the 3D object itself.
So is it making it in layers, or how is it making it 3D?
That's absolutely how it functions. The robot that's guiding the hot tip where it's melting is extremely patient,
mm-hmm.
and it can do very, very thin layers. Right now it's printing at 0.4 millimeters layer, so very, it'll build that up over a period of minutes into hours to create some of the objects that I brought with me today that I think we can take a look at.
So we're seeing right now at printing the penguins image that we saw on the computer, the logo. How long has it been going so far, and how long will it take to complete that?
This started printing roughly at 7:45 this morning.
Wow.
So 3D printing at the moment, depending on the size of the object that you want to print, it still can take a long time. Mm-hmm. The technology is getting better. The 3D printers are getting faster. That's why, again, inside of our lab, and the lab at the Science Center, we do have also have rapid prototyping technologies. So there are machines that can create things really, really quickly. And you learn how to use all those machines and put them together to make something. A good example of that.
Fascinating, yeah. So the 3D printer made all of these things?
It did not make all of that. Okay. It made the red parts that you can see.
I see.
So this is a quadcopter that a student designed and actually put together from scratch, sort of teaching the design process to go back, and it doesn't work the first time. You go back and do a redesign.
Uh-huh.
Anything you see in red.
Okay.
It was 3D printed. The cardboard, this is actually a quadcopter made out of cardboard.
Like a helicopter, but with four props.
Exactly,
okay.
Yeah. And that was made with the laser cutter. So you can actually use multiple machines to make something
amazing.
Like that.
And then it made these parts too?
Correct. So this is a prosthetic hand that we actually 3D printed with a program that we ran at the main Science Center Fab Lab called E-Enable. And this is a prosthetic hand that actually functions.
Oh,
but
my.
All the parts that you can see, the blue, in the clear, these were run on our 3D printer.
Oh, that's incredible.
Yeah.
And then you can just do fun things, right? Like faces or names or Pittsburgh, PA. That is so amazing.
Absolutely.
Is that kind of how kids start? I guess this would be like a model of a house or something.
This object that you actually picked up was designed by a fourth grader. So I'm not kidding. This individual sat at a computer and had very little 3D design experience.
Uh-huh.
Within 2 hours, he knew Frank Lloyd Wright and Falling Water, and inside of a 3D software, he created what he wanted to be his own sort of version, and we were able to 3D print that for him.
And did you say kids can do this at the Science Center as well?
Correct, yes. We have a Fab Lab located at the Carnegie Science Center as well.
Well, Jon, thanks so much for bringing the Mobile Fab Lab here to KDKA.
No problem. Thank you.
And if you'd like to have the Fab Lab come to your school, your group, your camp, contact the Carnegie Science Center, and it could be pulling up right outside your door this summer.